speaking of inspiring, I'd love to welcome up here to the podium the Renal Warrior. Today in house we have Mr. Wilson Du. A little brief bio about Wilson, aka hashtag Renal Warrior. He is a dialysis patient and a kidney disease advocate. As a patient, he made a physical transformation. It's a pretty incredible story. And currently trains like an athlete. On October 13th in 2018, he completed a 550-mile bike ride from San Francisco Bay Area all the way down to San Diego. Welcome to the stage, Mr. Wilson Du.
All right, so, my name's Wilson Du, Renal Warrior. How many dialysis patients in here? Perfect. And we got a bunch of transplant patients and whatnot. My talk is called The Mission. Everything revolves around a mission. My story starts as a kid in high school. I was always a big guy. I was probably getting into my senior year. I've always been somewhat of an athlete when I was younger in high school. I played football. I was a lineman. Going into my senior year, I was probably about 220, 230 pounds. And so after football season, no more spring training, no more working out. It was just enjoy my senior year, just hang out. Start eating a little bit, started gaining a little bit of weight, didn't have to go to the weight room anymore, so that was all good, but it was okay. Because one of these days, when I started college, I'm gonna be able to get in shape and get back in shape and do what I gotta do. So, graduated high school, started college, out here at San Jose State. New place, living in the dorms, making new friends, just enjoying my time. And you guys heard of the freshman 15?
Yeah.
Again, the freshman 50. I was up here in San Jose, it was great food everywhere, going out to eat all the time. And I always told myself, you know, it was okay. Because right now this is college, I'm supposed to have the time of my life. It's the best years of my life. I need to spend time making new friends, going out to parties, hanging out, because when I become an adult, that's when I'll have all the time to work out, right? Because we all have all the time to work out. So, freshman year, or in college, I graduated. I graduated and I probably left at about 250 to 260 pounds. But it was okay, absolutely fine, because like I said, when I was gonna become an adult, I would have all the time in the world. I could work out, I could eat right, I could do whatever I need to do. So I graduated, started work, and at that age, I graduated at 21 years old, and I got into the financial markets, real estate, mortgages. This was back in the early 2000s, and if any of you remember the early 2000s, the real estate market was booming. It was one of the hottest markets the country's ever seen, if not, you know, over here in the Bay Area. So I was a young kid making a ton of money. Fast life, fast cars, fast everything. But the one thing I didn't do, it was okay. I didn't exercise, I didn't take care of myself, because I kept on telling myself, it was okay. Because one of these days, when that next deal closes, I'm gonna start working out, I'm gonna start eating right, I'm gonna do all these things. Well, one of these days, I started having some pains in my ankles and then pains in my knee. It was gout. Many of us in here probably know what that is. One of the most painful things I've ever felt in my life. I dislocated my shoulders, I've broken bones, but nothing is as painful as gout. So, it was the left ankle. It's okay, still went to work, had a cane. Got to right ankles, okay, put the cane on the other side. And then both ankles, it's okay, crutches. Well, one day I woke up. One day I woke up, couldn't get out of bed. Gout inflammation, left ankle, right ankle, left knee, right knee, all four. Couldn't get out of bed. Couldn't walk to the bathroom. Only thing I could grab was the phone. Grab the phone. I can't get out of bed. I can't do anything. who do we call? We call 911. They come get me. When they come and get me, they had to bust down the door, grab me, brought me to the hospital. I already knew what was going to happen. It's gout. I already know what it is. So I know what the doctor's going to say. They're going to pull me in. The doctor's going to say, Wilson, you need to lose some weight. You're not young anymore. You got to do something about it. You need to go on a diet. You need to start exercising. I knew what the doctor was going to say. That's why I never went to go see him. So, doctor came in and said, yes, this is gout. Took labs, came back, yes, it's gout. But one other thing. I'm sorry, but you have stage 5 end-stage renal disease.
What?
Kidney failure. What? What is this? I can't really talk much about it. Tomorrow, the nephrologist will come in and give you your option and tell you what's really going on. What's going on. You see, when I was diagnosed, I was 315 pounds. I kept telling myself, one of these days. So one of these days caught up to me. Anyways, doctor comes in the next day. My good friend now, nephrologist, which I didn't like him when he came in, Dr. Wesley Lisker, came in and said, Wilson, I've seen this before. Your life's about to change. You better start making plans because you're going to start something called dialysis. Oh, no, 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 no. I don't start things like dialysis. I have to go back to work. I have these deals I got to close. Just, you know, give me the pill, do your surgery, do what you got to do. Fix me so I can get on. He's like, you don't understand. It doesn't work that way. You see, you dedicate yourself to all this work and you don't take care of yourself, and this is the end result of it. And you're not going to be going back to work for a little while. You're going to have to make arrangements and you're going to start something called dialysis. Oh, okay. What is this? He said, the only other option you have as a treatment other than dialysis is a kidney transplant. However, because of your weight, you're at 315 pounds. You're not going to qualify for a transplant unless you lose 100 pounds. And I looked at him, I go, are you nuts? I'm 315 pounds. You want me to lose 100 pounds? I can't walk right now. I have all this inflammation. I can't even walk. How do you expect me to do this? This is your fault. Fix this. No, it's not his fault. It was my fault. Long story short, a couple of months later, I swelled up 60 pounds worth of fluids in 2 weeks. I collapsed in the kitchen. I had to call 911 again, busted down the door again, grabbed me, brought me to the hospital. Here it is. I remember that day like it was yesterday. I started swelling up. I wanted to walk to the bathroom. As I got up, I collapsed. Got up again, collapsed. Couldn't get back up. They brought me in. Sure enough, because of my stubbornness, I did not want to get my fistula put in right away. So what they had to do, they stick a catheter through my chest into my heart. Started dialyzing me. I stayed in the hospital at that moment for about 6 weeks, 6 or 7 weeks. Ooh. The first day of dialysis, for some reason, after they dialyzed me, I started getting gout inflammation. Again, on my ankles, my knees, my elbows, my neck, my back. I laid there for 6 weeks. In the hospital, in the nursing home, filled with fluids. Getting dialyzed every other day in the hospital until they sent me off to a nursing home. Then they transport will come pick me up, take me in a gurney, take me to dialysis, dialyze me, bring me back over to the nursing home. From laying down for so long, my muscles atrophied. I couldn't walk. Gout was still there. The physical therapy in the nursing home got me to a point where I was able to use crutches, and they sent me home. I was completely broken, mentally, physically, spiritually. It was just a few weeks ago, I was out with my friends, my coworkers, living my life. Just a few weeks ago, my career was skyrocketing. Just a few weeks ago, I had so many hopes and dreams. And now all of a sudden, I only had one mission, was to live. One day after dialysis, transported me to the gurney, brought me back. Every day was the same. After dialysis, it was like, they bring me back. Do you want the bed? Or do you want the wheelchair? Because wherever they were going to put me, I was going to spend the rest of my day in there, wherever it was. I sat there in a wheelchair one day after dialysis, looking outside, just thinking, is this even worth living? I'm living, I can't, I'm stuck in a wheelchair. I have to be dependent on somebody. I can't even cheat on my food because my mom was taking care of me. She was giving me the food the doctors were prescribing. I couldn't even go and cheat. So she would bring me the food. But in the wheelchair, thinking about this, is this worth pursuing? Is this worth going forward with dialysis? I can't eat the foods that I eat. I can't go to the bathroom by myself. I can't do anything on my own. I have to live off of this machine. Life completely turned upside down. I had two options. Either one, stop this nonsense, stop dialysis. Number two, choose to fight. If I choose to fight, I'm going to fight this thing, tooth and nail. Not looking back, not giving up, I'm going to fight this thing. So at that moment in time, I had one of two choices, and I chose to fight. And from that day, after dialysis, as painful as it was, I got up off that wheelchair and I walked to the front door, as painful as it was, walked back, went to sleep for the rest of the day. But the next day, I did it again. The day after that, I walked again to the door. Day after that, did it again and again and again and again. And when I got a little bit stronger, I stepped outside the door. Another 5 or 10 feet into the patio. Did that day in, day out, day in, day out. Got a little bit stronger, walked down the block. Cane and crutches, doesn't matter. That was my goal. I only had one mission. That mission was to survive. And I was going to fight this thing. Down the block became, down the street became my first mile. I remember my first mile. I put it on video. I was the happiest guy ever. Took me 45 minutes with my mom trailing right behind me. Average person takes what? Maybe they could walk a mile in 15, 16 minutes. Took me 45 minutes, but I didn't care. I was the king of the world at that moment. And after I started that first mile, I knew that I can go a little bit further and a little bit further and a little bit further. And then all of a sudden one day I said, okay, let's try to jog 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Then all of a sudden, I'm doing 5Ks. I'm running 10Ks. I'm running half marathons. And then one day, somebody challenged me to go get on a bike. Get on a bike. Okay, let's get on a bike. 5 miles, 10 miles, 15 miles, 20 miles. And I remember January 2018, I took out my bike for the first time, and I rode it from Ontario, California, all the way to Palm Springs. 70 miles as a dialysis patient. Oh, it's not done yet. We're not done yet. So that was my second mission. First mission is to survive. I was thriving at that moment. Second mission was that bike ride. Now let me tell you a little bit about that bike ride. That first bike ride over from Ontario to Palm Springs, after walking and running and doing all of that for about a year, I made a physical transformation. Within 1 year, I was able to get down from 315 pounds down to about 220 pounds through diet and exercise, sheer diet and exercise. I remember going back to my transplant center and say, hey, I'm ready for the evaluation now. I think I could pass. They're like, oh, we have the wrong chart. Oh, no, that's not the wrong chart. That's me. So I made the physical transformation, and some of my colleagues from work in the past said, we haven't seen you. What happened to you? Well, I got sick. I got kidney failure. They're like, but you have such an incredible story right now. Why don't you come and speak at one of our leadership events? And by the way, can you do it in dramatic fashion? Sure. Can you ride in on a bike and actually do it? Sure, I can. Got a bike, and that was our second mission. So my second mission was doing that ride. And that was the first time I had ever publicly shared my story. It was in a room just like this. I shared that story, did the ride, and after I was done, so many people came up and said, look, I wish you can talk to my sister or my brother, or I had a loved one that just passed away, and I wish they heard this story, and that's where the Renal Warrior was born. At that moment, it was some of the folks that were in the audience said that, you know, we need to get this thing out there, and that's where I felt that we needed to go out there and share this story and talk to other patients, let other patients know that if we can move an inch, we can move a mile. That was the second mission. And in that speech, when I was giving that speech, I was so excited to tell this story. It was an emotional moment. It was finally getting out there and just letting people know that we can fight through this. And I was so excited that I said, you know what? We just did this ride from Ontario to over here to Palm Springs. I'm so excited. And you know what? By the end of the year, I'm going to ride from Sacramento all the way down to San Diego. Yeah! Oh, no. Did I just say that out loud? Mission number three was riding from the Bay Area to San Diego. You know, getting back to when I was diagnosed, one of the most scariest things, I didn't know much about kidney disease. That's why I told Dr. Lister, give me a pill or fix me via surgery. Do something. After he left, I did a simple Google search. Average lifespan of a person on dialysis. And Google, as it does, scares everybody. First thing that pops up says, average lifespan of a person on dialysis, anywhere between 5 to 7 years. 5 to 7. Okay, next thing. Who on dialysis has made a physical transformation while on dialysis? Now, I found a lot of people that are post-transplant that are doing marathons. I found a lot of people that are post-transplant doing triathlons, doing running 5Ks, doing centuries on their bikes. But who's on dialysis? Who's made the transformation? Because I was looking for that person so I could do exactly what they've done. Whatever their diet is, whatever their regimen is, I want to do what they've done. And I couldn't find anybody. So after I made the transformation, I wanted Renal Warrior to be out there so that other patients, when they're in the exact same similar situation, they can go out there and they can find it. So going back, our third mission was to ride from the Bay Area down to San Diego. I trained day in, day out. My regimen was waking up, walking over to the gym. After walking to the gym, I would train, I would walk over to another gym where I'd take a CrossFit class. After that, I would walk home, eat, rest up, bike for the rest of the day. Next day, dialysis. I did that day in, day out. Day in, day out. Dialysis days were my rest days. Other days, I would train. And you know, the one of the biggest things about training is that when I'm training with other people, I'm tired. I'm huffing and puffing. But you know what? They are too. So in a way, we're all at the same level playing. I just get tired a lot quicker. And train day in, day out. And right now, as of right now, you're looking, today is actually the 1 year anniversary of that ride. So what I'm gonna show you, it's a very special moment for me. So what I'm gonna show you is, I'm gonna show you a video of the transformation first off. And then what we'll do is we'll go into that bike ride and we'll show you what that looks like. All right?
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Keep on moving, keep climbing, keep the faith, baby.
Been to Palm Springs, the Ritz-Carlton was where we rode to, and it sits on the top of a mountain or top of a hill. And of course, I didn't know that until the last thing. I had to loop it twice to get over it. So after we did that ride, I got excited with biking. And that's when I blurted out that we're going to ride from the Bay Area all the way down to San Diego. So I started training for that. And got notice of a couple of filmmakers that was looking to do some work. So they're working on a documentary at the moment in post-editing. We're still working on funding and things like that. But so that's going to come out, and that's going to be for the Warrior Ride. So let me show you exactly a year ago what we did. The Warrior Ride.
At 34 years old, Wilson Dew was a hardworking Bank of America mortgage banker. At 315 pounds, he was dangerously overweight and suddenly found himself in the ER and diagnosed with end-stage renal disease or kidney failure. Today, 2 years and 130 pounds lighter, he's known as the Renal Warrior.
I was sitting there in a wheelchair and I said, I'm going to choose life instead of going the other path. And from that day, I picked myself up, and it was painful, but I started walking.
And now he trains like an athlete. In order to receive a kidney transplant, Wilson needed to lose the weight. Now that he qualifies for one, Wilson needs a live kidney donor.
So it takes a village.
So he's setting out on a great journey, cycling from the Bay Area to San Diego. Kidney disease is the ninth leading cause of death in the U.S. Wilson kicked off his ride at Dragon Rouge Restaurant in Alameda with family, friends, and support from the Asian Real Estate Association of America.
Most people who have kidney disease do not know they have until it's too late, like myself. So we're trying to raise awareness for that so that it can hopefully be prevented.
Wilson needs dialysis about four times a week. He's tied to a chair for up to 5 hours during each session, and he's still training hard.
Even though you're on dialysis, there's still a life that you can live on dialysis, that you can still move mountains as we will the next couple of weeks.
So one of the big things is, for me, is trying to do things in dramatic fashion as a dialysis patient. Why? It's to raise awareness for kidney disease. It's, you're looking at, if this is the ninth leading cause of death, and you're looking at 30 million people affected, and 50% of the people do not know that they have it, you're gonna have a lot of people that crash into dialysis like myself and like many of you others that are in here. You don't know about it, why don't we know about it? So let's do some things so that we can raise awareness for it. And this is what we're hoping to get with the documentary. So mission number three is to get that ride from here down to San Diego. And here's a teaser trailer of our documentary.
I was diagnosed with kidney failure in 2016. The ER doctor broke the news to me. I'd been rushed to the hospital. I'd woken up in the middle of the night. I couldn't move. I was in so much pain. The doctor told me undiagnosed high blood pressure killed my kidneys. At the time, I was tipping the scales at over 300 pounds. I had a choice to make. Sit and die or fight. Now I'm on a mission to inspire people to fight. I want to help people choose life, especially when things get tough. Riding my bike 500 miles from the Bay Area all the way to San Diego, I want to show that you can accomplish any goal, overcome any obstacle, even without a kidney. I'm still on dialysis. I'm still waiting on a kidney.
I'm looking for a living donor. And I started to ask myself, you know, can I leave this earth a better place than I came in?
My name is Wilson Du, and I'm the Renal Warrior.
We rode out exactly 1 year ago today. It took 13 days to complete, and we finished in San Diego on October 13th. I dialyzed it at six different locations throughout the state. Right now, which is the fourth mission, it's the Mission HQ. So one of the biggest things about my journey is that when I started joining the gym, I was always very, I wouldn't say shy, I was intimidated to go to the gym. You had all these people that were fit. I didn't want to ask a stupid question. I used to go in there at 4 or 5 in the morning when nobody was there, when no trainers, nobody, so I could just work out by myself. I didn't know what I was doing. But I was just doing it. And now, I can see how so many people, so many patients like us, will not even start going to the gym just because of that intimidation factor. Or if they start, they would easily stop because they're intimidated by it. So our fourth mission was to have a safe place for everybody, all patients, to go and actually work out in a safe environment, a judgment-free place, knowing that people in there have gone through what they've gone through. So we recently started a gym in Alameda. It's called the Mission HQ, dedicated for patients like us and other patients and elderly folks. You can come in, it's in Alameda, California, and you can train for free. There is classes designed to just build confidence to get you up to a level that you can take regular classes. And that's in Alameda. And this is a picture of me that tells the story on the flyer. That is Molly. Molly was my very first trainer. When I went to the gym and Molly said, look, I see you in here all the time. Why don't you just come in and train with me? I said, no, you don't understand. I have kidney failure. And she was very sensitive to what my condition was. And she helped train me and got me stronger to a point where I was able to do regular classes. And right now, Molly has joined the Mission HQ in training all of the chronically ill patients and elderly folks. So this is the fourth mission. We have two classes right now that are for the chronically ill and elderly and seniors. And then what's happening is we're waiting on funding and things like that so we can expand on those classes. But my main message to all of us in here that are on dialysis, if we can move an inch, we can move a mile. Doesn't mean that we're faced with dialysis or faced with some type of adversity that we can't do great things. We can still move mountains. Might be a little slower, but we can still do it. I'm here to tell you that, if you can move an inch, you can move a mile. That's what I kept telling myself. I just did it week after week after week. So we're all in this fight together. I'm fighting right alongside of you. So just thank you very much for allowing me to come over this week.
The Renal Warrior. Give it up for the Renal Warrior. Anyone have any questions at this time? We'll take a few questions. We're running slightly behind, but I think we've got time for some questions.
Yes, sir.
Bob?
Yeah, do you plan on expanding your HQ, your gym?
Yes, well, right now we're just trying to
hunkered down. We just opened a couple of months ago, and right now we have a couple of trainers. We have about maybe 7 patients that we're working with. But yeah, we're taking as many patients. Each class is going to be probably could fit up to 20 people. So we're looking to expand in the future, but right now we're just looking to make sure that we get settled down at where we're at right now. So. It's in Alameda, California. It's right next to Oakland. It's a little island off of Oakland. It's right off the freeway off of 880. So we have a few patients that are diabetic and their kidney functions have dropped. So what they're looking for is looking to sustain it so that they don't have to go into dialysis. Not to say that we can do that, but what we will do is fight right alongside of you and make sure we're going to do our best to keep it that way. So. Any other questions? Perfect. Thank you very much.
Thank you.